My dear friends, this is an introductory lecture or more details about the Total Quality Management 2 course being floated under NPTEL MOOC. And many of you must have done TQM1. My name is Raghunandan Sengupta from the Industrial and Management Engineering Department at IIT Kanpur in India. So, in TQM2, what we will be covering, I will give you that brief background. We will continue discussing that more later on. We will discuss who generally people who can take this course. Obviously, there can be other sets of people also interested in taking this course. And the last discussion would be about how the course would be planned. Obviously, many of you are well aware, but I will still discuss that. So, once again, welcome to this small introductory video for the TQM2. So, we will consider and go in depth. So, whatever bullet points I am giving are very general. I will go into the depth. So, we will consider the basic background in statistics, cover the concepts of what is probability distribution, consider what is concept of expected value, variance, expected value coming from the fact of first moment, variance coming from the fact of second moment, discuss though briefly, keep it limited. We will talk about the scale parameter, location parameter for the distributions, the three parameters which are there. I will come to that later on, and how these location, scale and shape parameter affect the expected value and the variance. I would not be going to details, but you will see that later on, and very simple examples will be discussed in the initial part. Then we will consider about go into the topic of point estimation, and before that obviously sampling concept, sampling distribution, the concept wise we will discuss how point estimation is utilized given the information from the population is not there for the parameters, how we will use from the sample to find out the point estimation. Then we will discuss how the interval estimation concept is done considering the level of confidence. And the main concept later on, which will be the precursor for the maximum part of this course, would be the precursors which you should discuss. It would be the hypothesis testing, how hypothesis testing problems are formulated, what we mean by the non-hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, the type 1 error, the type 2 error, and what implications they have for the experiment. Then we will go into the design of experiments, ANOVA, and obviously we will consider the MANOVA also, just very briefly. ANOVA definitely, a MANOVA very briefly. We will come to the related concept of factorial design, so how regression models are utilized in order to find out the concepts of design of experiments. So, use design of experiments to verify few facts. We go into different type of regression tests, factorial designs, how the experiments can be designed depending on the sample size, so on and so forth. We will go into quality engineering, that would be a little bit more qualitative because the main bulk design of experiments would be quantitative. So, we consider quality engineering, how the concepts of quality engineering are used. Then quality functional development, how the functions can be developed depending on the inputs and outputs which you have, how they can be utilized to manage quality on a much robust nature, robust scale. Robust word I am using in a very general English term sense. So, we will consider later on the process optimization, how they can be done, how they can have an effect on total quality management, how quality can be improved, what implication it has on the overall bearing on the quality of the whole scenario. We will consider robust product design and some concept of quality engineering will come here in this concept. We consider management of quality principles and the ultimate principles of quality and their implication for the improvement of the whole process. So, this is in a short, concise manner what we will discuss. Obviously, things would be discussed in more details as we continue. Problems will be discussed in the lectures. You will be given assignments as per the norm, whatever you all know. And the book which will be followed would be the classical book of Montgomery of Design of Experiments. And if it is not available in the library, you are definitely it's quite costly. Don't worry about that. You can just go to the library, check what are the contents, and mix the relevant photocopies as per the norm. The slides, because as they are being all from Montgomery, we would not put up the slides on the net. So, obviously, people can refer the lectures and refer to the book in the library, or if you have this classical book, you can refer that. Now, who can take this course? So, it is basically more for the master's level, people in the business administration doing an MBA want to basically go into depth of quantitative techniques, they can take, people in economics can take, people who are masters in statistics and mathematics who want to go into this level of statistical quality control and related topics can utilize these concepts. People who are in industrial engineering management, who want to use industrial engineering concept, operational research and basically work on the shop floor, design the different innovative process control methods, go into the depth of the manufacturing process or the continuous flow process, even in service industry they can utilize that to improve the productivity and the efficiency of the system, they can use that. People who are masters in operation research and operations management can use that. People who are working in the area of supply chain management, who are working in different type of inventory control systems, they can use that in order to learn the different concepts of quality and mainly design of experience, how they can be used. And people who are in the PhD program in related fields, they can definitely use this concept later on. But obviously, you have to go into the depth by referring to the book, as I am saying in the last few minutes, but book would be the main emphasis. So, what can you expect to achieve from this course? You will have a better appreciation of quality quantitative tools and their use, how they can be used, what is the concept of F distribution, chi-square, T distribution, factorial design, then Bartlett's test, how you are going to do the QQ plot, check the normality, and even if they are not normal, how you are going to check the chi-square, what chi-square distribution consequence it has on the standard error or the square of the standard error from the sample, what implication it has, we will consider. We will also consider if there are other distribution, how central limit theorem can be utilized to use hypothesis testing to solve simple problems. We will consider design of experience in a big way and its wide use in statistical model design, how we can design on what are the factors based on which you are going to do the experiment, what is the sample size, what are different calculations you are going to use. We will use simple concept of statistics like ANOVA, analysis of variance, MANOVA, multivariate analysis of variance, factorial design to conduct different type of useful experiments in order to understand quality in its actual depth and implication. Now, other details of the course, it is a 20 lecture course, each week we will have 5 lectures, each being of half an hour. So, obviously, we will have a total duration of 8 weeks, which is 40 lectures, and after each and every week, there would be one assignment. So, total will be 8 assignments along with that fact that there would be one end terms also as per the norm of NPTEL. And obviously, we would be as a team at NPTEL and other set of people would be there who are TAs, who are faculty members, I would be there, we will be answering questions as and when the queries come up, as and when the course goes. But obviously, we will appreciate from our end, we will request that people do go into the details of the slides, do understand the concept from the book and definitely it will be much fruitful discussion happening between people who are taking this course and people who are basically teaching this course. With this, I will end this small introductory lecture and hope there would be a wide audience who would be utilizing this course in order to basically engage them more fruitfully in the concept of quality and use the concept of quality in its literary sense, in its quantitative sense, in its qualitative sense in order to improve the general working principles of life in either in factory or in other spheres. Have a good day and thank you very much.